France versus Croatia, the game the world is waiting for. It isn't the only remaining game, though. There is one tie before that, which we must not forget. Before Moscow stages the finale, the World Cup caravan will move to St. Petersburg for one last time for a match where pride, more than just the proverbial kind, is to play for. Belgium and England have met at this World Cup before in a Group G final game which wasn't of great consequence. The two teams will now have to egg themselves on to not let slip the consequence of this one. The bronze medal at Russia 2018 is on the line when two familiar foes, given the heavy Premier League presence in both setups, square off in the third place playoff at St. Petersburg on Saturday. Actually, so much praise for Gareth Southgate and Roberto Martinez through this World Cup. Southgate for marshalling his troops, Martinez for that tactical triumph over Brazil in the quarterfinal. But is this perhaps the most difficult game as a coach to motivate your team, motivate your players for? They just the hurt from the semi-finals is still just so fresh.
Yeah, I think so, without a doubt. Obviously, Belgium have had an extra day to psychologically come to terms with it. England were so close, and that'll be hurting. You know, it's a tricky one for a coach. You know, what team do you put out? Do you try and give people minutes that haven't had any minutes before, just so they've played in a World Cup campaign, or do you try and put your strongest team and win it? I'm pretty sure throughout the media, both managers will be saying the same thing: we want to finish third. But is that the truth? Are they really going to attack this game with all their might? It's tough. It's tough to motivate the players. I'm pretty sure the way the England lads are feeling at this precise moment is just get me home, get me out of here, get me on a beach. But a couple of days' time, they'll get a chance to get over it, and then they might start thinking about, you know, come on, let's finish third. Third is better than obviously fourth.
Give us the players' perspective on this, Eugene. How easy or tough is it to put such a big disappointment from a semi-final behind you? Because while you will, of course, you don't mean any disrespect to this contest, but as Ashley put out, a third-place playoff is not what the world remembers once the World Cup ends.
Obviously, he's put it right, actually. Like, I mean, as a player, you'd feel really, really depressed. You'd feel low. You'd feel it'd be very hard to come to terms that you've actually missed out on a final. But I mean, like, when you know you're out there representing a country, so eventually you have to go out there and finish it. You know, as a sports person, as a professional that you are, you have to go there and, you know, give what you have to give. Give your best, no matter what it is.
All right. Predictions, very quickly.
0-0.
All right, we'll see if that comes true. We've been calling on you, the viewer, to send in your predictions through the knockouts as well. Let's see which of you have cause for celebration. Not many touted Croatia to get the better of England, but congratulations to Manjeet Kumar, Shweta Yadav and Shubham. You all have a Kindle coming your way sometime soon for your correct calls from last night.